Howdy folks, thanks for stopping in. Today I'll be talking about three different topics. The first topic is Rudy. In case you're wondering, well, why haven't I been fishing before today? Well, we have a new member of the family. I've been spending a lot of time in and out cleaning feet. Topic number two is Binder Lake, where yesterday I had an opportunity to put in my pontoon boat with the new gas engine that I got last December. And lastly, I'm going to just make a few comments about ElaZtech lure storage. So topic number one is Rudy. He's Brenda's new Papillon, and he's been with us for 8 days now. And he's probably about 9.5 weeks old, something like that. They really do grow up fast. Here's a picture of them when we first got them, and here's a more recent picture of them, and you can see how they change really fast. I'm just kidding, Rudy. You're being pretty good.
Look, Rudy, go get it. He's a slider.
Good sliding, boy. Being pretty good. Okay. Next topic is Binder Lake.
Howdy, folks. I'm driving over to Binder Lake here in Jefferson City. It's just a few miles from the house. I don't have any clue what binder fishing is like this time of the year. I checked last year's logs, and what a difference a year makes. Last March was just terrible in terms of weather, snow, wind, that sort of thing. So today, the temperature forecast and the barometric pressure was almost too good to be true. So I said, well, I better get out there while I've got an opportunity. See, not a big throng of people here waiting to get in at the launch ramp. Weed whacker a try. What do you say? We arrived safely without sinking or blowing up on the other side of the lake, and we're sitting in 23 feet of 45 degree water at the moment. Shad balls. It's looking very familiar. I caught a fish. Yay! Come on, don't you get off now. Looky here. This is absolutely nothing to write home about, but it's a fish, and he or she, hard to say, grabbed something that you probably haven't seen me use before, and that's a TRD with a tail spinner. Pretty cool, huh? There'll be more on this Finesse Bullets rigged TRD tailspin later in the season, I'm sure. Well, looky here. It's another object resembling a fish. I saw a couple of guys out here in an aluminum boat earlier today, and they were here for quite a while. I didn't see them catch anything. With all these shad out here, I'm surprised it bit today. This is a new lure I'm using. It is a Combat Jigs Tomahawk. Inch and a half long, little bitty squirt.
We'll get your measurement and put you back today because I got lots of crappie in the freezer. And today I'm just exploring binder secrets anyway. So just a second. At least fat. It only comes in around 11. 11, 11 and a quarter. Catch you and maybe some of your buddies this spring. See ya. And these tomahawks come in all kind of cool colors. Can't wait to see what they do when the water gets up just another degree or two. Okay, I traditionally do not use a pink jig head. Our friend, old Garrett Fishing Chums, suggested that folks were catching quite a few crappie in the southwest lakes down in the Ozarks using chartreuse with a pink jig head. So I said, well, I'll try a pink jig head and with a little monkey milk on it just to see what happens. Okay, what do we got here? Come here, buddy. But we've got some of your relatives in the freezer already. So give this little tomahawk a big smooch. And we'll catch you next time. Oops, sorry. Banged his head. We're out here in 31 feet when that one smacked it about 10 feet down. Interesting. Final score was 1 small bass, 3 small crappie, and a little bit more information about binder in March.
Topic number 3 is ElaZtech lure storage, what to do, what not to do. This is an area where I'm really familiar with it, but in many cases it seems that my experience hasn't been the same as the general public out there. So I'll just tell you what's happened on this end. Number 1, do not ever put an ElaZtech lure in with regular plastisols. That stuff will just all melt together, because the formulas are different and they'll just all disintegrate and create a gigantic mess. So the best thing to do is to separate your ElaZtech stuff completely from other lures. Ziploc bags, and I've never had any trouble with that at all. Most of us put our bulk packages of lures in some kind of plastic bin or box. That's a very good idea, good way to store them. And by putting a label on the outside of the box, you can avoid putting any other kind of lures in there and keep your bulk ElaZtech stuff separate. Let's talk about small storage areas. And here, for example, is a Plano box. And if you can see what this says, it says 2.5 inch zinkers. And the reason I brought this out to show you is that these zinkers have been in here probably 8 years or so. When the Ned Rig craze began, TRDs weren't even out there yet. So what people were using, myself included, was 5-inch zinkers cut in two to where they're 2.5 inches long, and the lures were mounted on a mushroom-style head, either 1/8 or 1/16 ounce. And all of these zinkers have been super glued to these original mushroom-style jig heads. And the main point I'm trying to make here is that these lures have been in this container for all that time, and they're not running together. They're just fine. There's no leakage. There's no dissolution. I haven't used these since I made them, but they still work great. So I'm going to try to use my zinkers this year a little bit more, because there's absolutely nothing wrong with them. These are really good little lures. These little boxes like this allow me to make these things ahead of time, and there's no problem whatsoever. They're not dissolving, they're not doing anything. They're just sitting in there waiting their turn to catch something. If you've had issues with the ElaZtech lures dissolving, all I can say is I've used these small containers like this very, very successfully for years. Never had anything dissolve or go out of whack of it. It's still early here in the central part of Missouri. The weather this week is looking pretty good. Might have an opportunity to get out a little bit more. So until we see you again, have a wonderful day, a wonderful week, and God bless.